invite your dove of love to sit on your shoulder, because our Lord is a bridge over troubled water. Welcome to this video, and this is to lift up my wife. And we all need to listen to these words, because when we're weary and feeling small, the Lord is promising us to wipe away our tears and to get rid of our fears, our festering ones. And if we listen to the inspired word, the Lord is saying, I am on your side. And it's a blessed stream in the middle of a desert, an oasis. And this is, the Lord is my shepherd. My soul shall not want. He leadeth me in green pastures. He restoreth my soul. And we can lay down and rest, knowing that He is the bridge over troubled water. And it's time that we all lay down our past. Our past is gone. Our future is here now. And it's just ahead. But today is the only day that we can bank upon. So it's time to get excited. And it's time to rev up the word of love. And in this hour, let it ring, let it ring, let it ring. And in this time, I'm so excited to bring forth a word of love in this hour that is so desperately needed all across the world. And this is a call and an invitation from the great white throne for people obedient unto the word of love to grab a hold of their better half and to never let them go. For love is not even love unless it is given away. And there is no marriage that can ever last unless there is unconditional love. And so in this hour, it's time to speed things up. And the only way that we can really speed it up is by realizing the truth that love always wins and that we get back what we put out. It is the law of sowing and reaping. So praise the Lord that these are beautiful days that we can finally sail away by love's finest sails. For the wind of love is full and the tide of love is going to drown everyone who's not paying attention. So please pay attention. So it's time that all of us, including myself and my beloved wife Linda, it's time for all of us to lift up our anchors. Get ready, get set. It's time to hoist up our most vibrant colors of the pride of the roaring lion of Zion. For while mindless sheep have flocks for their families, all family of lions have always been called a pride. So let all people seek ye first the Lord's kingdom of love, because He is love. And all those who love are born of God and born again and know Him, because He is love. 1 John 4:7. And so seek ye first the kingdom of love, whispers heaven unto all of us, and then all things shall be added us unto us, as the law of sowing and reaping so rightly has demanded. And as John Lennon rightly said, so is it true that the love we make is the love that we take. Because that's what we take home at the end of the day. For we all get back only that which we put out. And so know that if you start putting out more love, you're going to get more back. And it's worth the effort. It's worth the exercise. If you don't use anything, you invite pain. Exercise needs to happen. So let's exercise our hearts in this hour of the restoration of all things. For these are the days of Elijah, and it's time for increased understanding. So no more will we have to look through a glass darkly, but rather that we can arise and smile with our sun of love who's rising to destroy all gross darkness of our imagination, to bring forth a wildfire of his loving kindness, one heart at a time, passionately erupting as a great overflowing great crescendo of our Lord's ending age of grace. So let the wise now prepare for his love's most beautiful climax of the ages, as that lamb-hearted lion and lion-hearted lamb becomes the good shepherd over all the flocks of man, as he roars aloud his kingdom age new covenant of Jeremiah for all people. So he says unto all mankind, he says, I shall be your God, you shall be my people. I shall forgive your iniquity, and I shall never remember it again. I shall write my law and my love upon your hearts. Beyond that, none shall ever need to be taught of me any more, saith the Lord. For all shall know me, whose love is alive as a little child. So leave the land of the walking dead, where people have had their verb-like love as a child to become just a noun, just a thing going nowhere, doing nothing. Dead love is dead faith. And so in this hour, it's time to arise, shine, for the light of love has come. And so it came to pass, to our great surprise, that Linda and I were blessed most abundantly. And it happened as the word of love from the great white throne came forth from us. And it was like a beautiful love song, melody and harmony dancing with one another. And it then became clear to see that both Linda and I, we couldn't help hearing the velvety voice of our golden-tongued orator of creation, who is Emmanuel. And as it came forth, one thing is for sure, we knew that the curse would be reversed, and we knew that it would happen, no matter what interruptions might come, that we would be overcomers. And so praise the Lord that he has his way in the storm, and the dust truly are, the clouds are but as dust under his feet. And when he spoke, the heavens suddenly exploded like a starburst, as the sapphire of heaven above thundered away with multitudes of lightning flashes, accompanying the Lord's most electrifying rolling thunderbolts that so easily pierced both of our hearts, a lot easier than Cupid ever dared to imagine. And then he who is the blessed, the beloved, and the adored, then he softly echoed the inspired word of his servant Cahil Gibran to our deepest heart of hearts. So our Lord of Lords then ever softly said unto us, when you both start getting weary by feeling small, know that when tears come into your eyes, I will dry them all. For I am love who's always on your side. And that hero of heroes and icon of icons then told Linda and I that if times get tough and friends just can't seem to be found, then he promised that our living love would always then be serving us and would go ahead of us and be like a bridge over troubled water, so we could both lay down all of our former fears by letting our perfect love effortlessly cast them all away. And that carpenter of the ages then gleefully, joyously said unto us, rejoice, for when you are both feeling down and out, and as evening falls so hard, know well that as your Lord of peacefulness, I will not only comfort you both, but evermore shall I take your part. I will take your part, especially if any darkness comes, so pain does not have to come all around. And as Linda and I received his overflowing word of promise, we rejoiced, for the day of celebration for us had finally come, because Jesus Christ Almighty had revealed unto us that he's always truly been his blessed bridge over our troubled water. And so in this hour, I can't urge everyone enough. It's time to reverse our curses. So it came to pass, as if in a vision, then we heard the voice of Emmanuel say unto our sailboat. He then said words of a great adventure, of a brand new hopes that would be ahead. And he then lovingly said unto Linda with a little laugh, with lots of glee. And then he said unto her and said, "Sail on, silver girl, sail on by, for your time has come to shine, and all your best dreams of love, hope, peace, and love's faith are finally on their way. See how they shall shine most radiant with the resplendence of the stars and the moon." And the Lord said, "And never stop reaching for the stars, for there really are footprints on the moon." And he said, "And if you need a friend, know that I am the Lord your healer, who loves sailing right behind you, so that my bridge over your troubled water will always ease your mind." So rest your heart, Linda, and excite all of your passions. And at this glorious time of Christ revealing that he's always been the living bridge over all the troubled waters of Linda and my marriage, I can't help thinking back to the very first time, I saw my wife Linda's shining face, for I couldn't help thinking that the sun was arising within her eyes, and it seemed like the moon and the stars were aglow by reflecting her shining smile that was certainly born of love's most beautiful frowns all turned upside down. And in that moment, I immediately understood that my Lord Jesus had not only prepared her for me, but also I for her, by the very best gift of his endless unconditional love that his majesty of majesties first gave unto all children of his love's greatest hopes. And so it's time that we realize that this word of love is for all lovers in love, and that we must embrace love, because the mystery of God as just in between a marriage, no relationship can ever last until the end unless it is unconditional love that's hanging on in there. And that is why I am celebrating, because that's my love for the wife of my youth, and that's her love for me. But one thing is for sure, when I kissed that darling woman, Linda, it was as if the earth was moving in my hand like a captive bird that was reflecting the greatest glory of the Lord's most glorious dove of love, whose whitest wings we always mount up upon. As he transformed, he becomes love's most regal eagle of the eons. And when that most glorious bird of prophecy first fluttered his whitest wings over both Linda and I together, he then ever so lovingly said a beautiful message unto us. And the message was one of love. And we heard the voice of love radiate in the heavens and echo all throughout. And we heard, and the voice said, "Follow your heart, create peace, fall in love, show gratitude, enjoy the little things. It's time to dream big, believe in your miracles and discover your passion, be spontaneous, embrace every possibility, believe in yourselves. Your lives are happening right now." And we rejoiced ever in that. And it was so comforting to our souls. And so it came about that when he came forth, he said unto us also, he says, "When your everlasting Lord of love beckons you to follow him, even though his ways are hard and steep, follow him. And when his wings enfold you, yield unto him. And even though the sword hidden among his pinions might wound you, follow him. And when he speaks to you, as love, believe him." And though love's voice might shatter your dreams, believe, love. And as the north wind lays waste to the garden, so shall love waste all distorted, unloving love. And know that even as love crowns you both, so shall he crucify both of you, crushing you little by little. For even as he is for your growth, so is he also for your pruning. And even as he ascends unto our highest heights and caresses your tenderest branches that quiver in the sun, so too shall he descend unto your roots, and so then shall he shake them in their clinging to the earth. So blessed be the name of the Lord, who is the living sower and the reaper of all of our harvests of love. And so it's time for the great harvest to beat the sword into the sickle for the harvest that is now drawn nigh. I heard the Lord say, and it'll be like sheaves of corn that he will gather unto himself, and he will thresh you and Linda and make you both naked before him. For he shall sift you in order for you to be free from your husks. So no more after this shall he have to grind you down to a whiteness. For he shall now knead you and knead you just as you're kneading some bread. He will knead you until you are pliable and flexible. It's time to put our stubbornness behind us. And then the dove of love said, and then shall your Lord assign you to his sacred fire, that you might become the sacred bread for God's sacred feast. And these things shall love do for you and Linda, that you might finally know the most well-kept loving secrets of your heart. And in that knowledge, so shall you both become fragments of life's living heart of hearts that shines with a joy so tremendous that the joyfulness thereof makes all happiness be turned right inside out unto utter, vibrant, exuberant joy let loose, happiest happy ever imaginable. So the Lord said, but if you do fear, know that if only you will seek love's peace and seek love's pleasure, then it will be far better for you both than anything else. And he shall cover your nakedness and pass out both of you upon love's threshing floors. And you shall be changed into the seasonless world where you shall laugh always and not go with the flow, but to break free from all restraints, to come out of the box, to laugh about having been in there so long. But the Lord says that, but not all of your tears have been in waste. Many have been the very water beneath the boat that we are both sailing away on. So the Lord speaks unto all people of love, saying the same thing, that him as the bridge over your troubled water will now glorify your situation. For the Lord says, love gives nothing but itself, and it takes nothing but from itself. For love possesses not, nor would it ever be possessed. For love is sufficient unto love. And when you love, you should not say, God is in my heart, but rather you should say, I am in the heart of God, who is my beloved love of the ages. And think not that you can direct the course of love, for love, if it finds you worthy, will direct your course. For love has no other desire but to fulfill itself. But if you love if you must let your needs have desires, let these be your desires, to melt and to be like a running brook that sings its most beautiful melody until the night, so that you too can know the pain of too much tenderness, to be wounded by your very own understandings of love, and to bleed willingly and joyfully, to be able to wake up at dawn with a winged heart and give thanks for another day of loving, to rest at the noon hour and meditate upon love's finest ecstasy, to return home at the eventide with the gratitude, and then to sleep with a prayer for the beloved in your heart and a brand new song upon your lips. For you, O Lord Jesus, alone are love, and you shall know that He is the living victory over a very badly destroyed marriage, now healed by that doctor of doctors, that great physician, revived from utter lifelessness, resurrected. And so let all of your marriages now rise up in the name of Jesus. Let Him be the flame of love's greatest passion that will relight both of your wicks. For there is no way we can make it until the end of our roads unless we know what we know, and we know His love is totally unconditional for us. For He loved us long before we first loved Him. True story. Couldn't make that up. Love you, Linda. And, oh, it's Linda's birthday, August 9th. So everybody in the world on August 9th at, let's say, 8 o'clock, make sure that you all turn off all your electricity just for one moment of silence for the wife of my little. I love you forever. Me too.
I know. Ciao, ciao.